I'm here with the Chief Executive of Fortescue Metals Group, Nev Power, at the beginning of the second day of the 2015 Macquarie Securities Australia Conference. The mining industry, and particularly the iron ore price, are being closely watched by investors as growth in China slows and demand contracts. At the same time, supply is increasing, causing questions to be raised about the viability of smaller producers. Nev, thanks for your time this morning.
It's good to be here, Hannah.
Talk me through the highlights of your presentation.
My presentation this morning is going to provide an update on Fortescue. In particular, I'll be focusing on our cost journey. We've guided for the end of this financial year to be at a production cost of $20 a tonne and for FY16 at $18 a tonne. Secondly, I'll be talking about our refinance, where we have now refinanced our short-term maturities out to beyond 2019. The bond raising we did in the US just recently meant that we've taken the 2017, 2018 and 2019, part of the 2019 bonds, and pushed those out to 2022. In addition, I'll be giving a general update on the Chinese market.
Increased iron ore production has been a key driver for price weakness over the last 12 months. How far away do you think Australia is from its peak iron ore supply?
Well, I think in terms of the market for iron ore now is so concentrated globally with four major players supplying the majority of that iron ore. So the extent to which volumes are expanded will determine the market. If we look at the longer term, China's steel market is very strong in the long term, but right now it's going through a small plateau. Everyone forecasts that the steel demand would go to 1 to 1.2 billion tonnes, but at the moment it's around 830 to 850 million tonnes. So that means that we need to trim production to manage to that market. In terms of Australia, I think Australia's got wonderful potential to continue expanding iron ore in the future, but what we need to do as producers is to make sure that the market is there for that expansion.
And you touched a minute ago on the plateau in China. When do you think we're likely to see that demand pick up again?
There are very positive signs coming out of China at the moment. There have been stimulus packages released, which are focused on developing much needed infrastructure in China, particularly in mass transit. And of course, the One Belt, One Road project is very important to China to opening up trade barriers, not only seaborne trade, but also overland trade. I think measures like that will see the stimulation of the Chinese economy to a point where steel demand continues to grow.
Will production cuts start to offset the remaining organic growth projects, or do you think we're likely to see an increased volume over the next 2 to 3 years?
I think volumes will drift up organically, but I don't see the justification or the likelihood of major capital expansions. I think everybody's looking at ensuring that they get good, solid shareholder returns for the capital they invest, and I can't see any rational argument for people to continue to invest and expand in this current market.
And despite difficult market conditions over the last 12 to 24 months, Fortescue's continued to generate positive cash margins due to increased productivity and also obviously a cost cutting. Is that sustainable in the current price environment moving forward?
Everything we've done in terms of our operating costs, Hannah, is sustainable. There have been permanent reductions in our costs, and we're continuing on that journey as we optimise and improve the productivity and efficiency of our business. A key driver for us has been optimising the production from each of our mines to make sure that we've got the right blend across our portfolio. So everything we've done is sustainable.
And just finally, Nev, in terms of the iron ore price, where do you think we're likely to see that head over the next 12 months?
Given the current market conditions, it's very difficult to predict where the iron ore price is going. I think if we look at the long-term demand from China, that remains strong. In the short term, we've seen a turnaround in sentiment on the futures market, which is driving the iron ore price where it is at the moment. And for the last perhaps 9 months or so, the iron ore market has been in physical supply-demand balance. So I think those are all very positive signs. Hopefully we'll see continued improved sentiment on the back of the stimulation packages that have been released in the Chinese economy.
Definitely a very interesting time. Thanks very much for your time this morning.
Thank you, Hannah.